just a little bit crazy, and nothing can help. I'm not even worth saving. Just wanna freak out.
Hey, this is Mia, and we are talking to Krista today.
Hey.
Krista's currently opening up for Kelly Clarkson.
Yes.
How did that come about?
She called me up and was like, "Hey, you want to perform?" And I was like, "Yeah." And she was like, "Cool." And I was like, "All right, I'll be there." And she was like, "Dope." No, I'm joking.
That would be cool, though.
If that happened, right? Totally, people would be like, "Oh my God, she's cool with her like that." No, actually, we're both signed to the same label, and I got the opportunity last February to open up for her in Atlantis on Valentine's Day. And, Atlantis in the Bahamas. In the
Caribbean. Dang.
Yeah, it was awesome.
So they flew you out there? And
yeah. Flew me out there, picked me up.
Happy Valentine's Day, yeah.
Yeah, right. I was single, so like, there's happy Valentine's Day to me alone.
Oh, but I mean, I imagine though that being out there and meeting some fans and being like, "Hey, I'm opening up for Kelly Clarkson,"
yeah,
that could have helped you.
Yeah, that was totally not a help at all.
Oh.
No, I'm joking. I'm joking with you. It was awesome. Like Valentine's Day in the Bahamas, like. And I'm there because, like, I'm performing. That's, like, a dream come true, you know? So I really didn't care. I didn't have a Valentine.
Growing up in Brooklyn,
yeah.
Dream come true for you. Tell me, the name of your album is Taking Back Brooklyn.
Yeah.
Who took it away in the first place?
It's not really, anybody taking it away. It's just that, artists like Jay-Z and Biggie Smalls, and just, they took Brooklyn and they claimed it. And as far as they go, the only other person right now that has, success even half as much as they have right now is Little Mama from Brooklyn. You know what I mean? And so I just want to be one of those artists who takes Brooklyn back and reclaims them and represents Brooklyn to the fullest.
Yeah, and a different style, too. I mean, like, when I was listening to Temporary Insanity, which is a hot single, it sounded to me like a mixture of like Evanescence and maybe Lady Sovereign.
I mean, it was a little awkward at first to incorporate the rapping because I didn't want people to, I don't know if chastise is the right word, but I didn't want them to tease me or judge me and kind of like pigeonhole me into like being this rapper. You know, I'm very much a singer first and foremost, and rapping is just kind of what I do to have fun. And, in some songs on my album, I just felt like it called for it naturally. Like, I felt like I had a little more attitude than singing would help express. So I wrote a rhyme.
Being on Kelly's tour, has she given you any advice, I guess?
Yes, she did, actually.
Anything that really sticks out?
Excuse me. Yeah, the last show, it was kind of a little bit of a struggle for me to perform to the best of, to the best of my ability, I felt. And,
Just not feeling it that day, or?
I wasn't feeling me that day. And I kind of was really hard on myself, and she came over to me kind of to celebrate because it was our last show together. And I kind of was, sobbing, being a drama queen. She came over and she was like, "What's the matter?" She's like, "Let me tell you something. Nobody knows that you're having a bad day. Only you know you're having a bad day because we're our own worst critics. And you gotta, roll with the punches and take every day for what it is and just be grateful that you are where you are. And, it's not always gonna be like that, the people out in the audience could have, probably thought that was your best performance because you were trying so hard even though you felt like you weren't on point. And there are days where you feel like you're the most on point, and those are the days when people didn't think you were that great, She's like, "So don't be so hard on yourself." And she was like, "I was where you were a couple of years ago, and I was where you were even a couple of days ago. But we still kicked ass, and we still pulled through because that's who we are." And that inspired me a lot.
I love me some Kelly Clarkson.
I really do.
Well, so you're going to perform a song or two for us?
Yeah.
Which ones are you going to be singing?
I'm going to be singing Crash and Burn and Temporary Insanity.
Excellent. Well, awesome. Thank you very much, Krista, for joining us.
No problem.
And we look forward to hearing from you.
Thank you.